Hello to everyone. My name is Livia Yermakova, and I am from All Russia Scientific Research Institute for Geology and Mineral Resources of the Ocean. And also, I am a representative of Russian contractor. And I would like to talk a few thoughts about monitoring and collaboration between contractors, both from contractors and scientific points of view. As all of you know, there are three contract areas in the northern part of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge: Polish, French, and Russian. Russian contractor have done the procedure of relinquishment this year, so currently we have our contract area is a half of the initial area. An obligation of contractor to perform monitoring of impacts, to adopt monitoring programs, as well as gather environmental baseline data. All these obligations are established by regulations on prospecting and exploration for polymetallic sulfides. Also, each contract consists the same obligations of contractors. Recommendations for the guidance of contractors for the assessment of the possible environmental impacts clarify the space of monitoring among other types of environmental studies. So there are two types of environmental studies: baseline and monitoring. And in turn, monitoring can be divided into monitoring during prospecting and exploration activities and monitoring during and after mining tests. But all of these documents have in mind monitoring and baseline studies inside contract areas, first of all. But there is a necessity of baseline studies and monitoring outside contract areas too, including the areas of particular environmental interest. Also, the situations are possible when any impact from the activity of any contractor can reach any area under another contract exploration or exploitation. So questions arise in this regard: who and when will do baseline studies and the monitoring in all such cases, and what will be the procedure for such monitoring and baseline studies? The next point relates to the holistic nature of the ocean. So these currents unite all parts of the ocean into the single system. Water masses with their own properties, which are different, and they have different boundaries, which do not match with boundaries of contract areas. Population connectivity assumed the exchange of individuals for other long distances. All of these aspects tell us about the necessity for a holistic study, not only for the study inside any separate contract area. And what should be studied during the monitoring? Base for monitoring is the results of environmental baseline studies. According to the recommendation, there are six groups of such studies: physical and chemical oceanography, geology, biological communities, bioturbation, and sedimentation. So the question is, do contractors study all of these groups of data in appropriate volume? I cannot tell for other contractors, but as for Russian contractors, of course, we have a number of points in which we need to do more strong studies and in which we need to increase volumes of our studies. And one of the consequences of not enough volume of environmental baseline study is knowledge gaps. In this slide, you can see a row of a list of knowledge gaps which were devoted for the northern part of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. It was discussed in the previous workshop at EVER last year. And this list is not full, but it, as you can see, it relates to different aspects: topography, currents, habitat, connectivity, responses of different marine organisms to impact, possible impacts of mining, and so on. And it's impossible to fill all these gaps just with studies inside own contract area. And what methods should be used for monitoring? In case, in situation when we have data from different entities, we need to make this data comparable. So we need standardization, of methods and equipment, of taxonomy, of DNA barcoding. And how we can reach that? So one point is use of documents of the ESA. Of course, we have recommendations which give us initial level for methods and equipment standardization. But now currently the guidelines for performance of baseline environmental data are drafted, and they give contractors a more detailed picture for such methods and equipment. For taxonomy, very useful different taxonomic workshops. For example, in the September of this year, workshop on deep sea taxonomic standardization was organized. Similar workshops were organized in previous year for the CCZ, and their results are very important for the standardization in this area of experience. Also for biology, some standards can be took from different databases. For example, for DNA barcoding, it's GenBank and Bol systems. Also, there is a global biodiversity information facility which accumulates different data standards. But contractors need to discuss these standards and make some decisions about regarding that, which standards they will follow. And other important point is discussion of development of intercalibration between different methods. Because if in some cases it's possible to use different methods, but to come with comparable results because of intercalibration. We need to develop this direction too. The ocean is a changing system, so it's simultaneity of measurements and observations is very important. And in history of oceanographic studies, we have a number of examples of such simultaneous studies. For example, it's International Polar Years, different experiments like VOSE or GeoTraces. During these experiments and Polar Years, a number of different measurements and observations were done in the same time in different part of the ocean according to the pre-agreed program. And I think it's a very useful way for the studies by contractors of our region and the other region where deep sea minerals are studied. And in a situation when the transition from exploration to exploitation can become in the not too distant future, and in case in situation when we need to develop regional environmental management plan and so on, the first sharing of scientific data and information also becomes important. Of course, we have a deep data database organized by the ASA, but it is not work in the full volume yet. And besides that, contractors give their results for this year in the next year. But sometimes it's important to have more fast changing of data and information. And I guess that every contractors create their own databases and they can share them. But in this case, we need to reach alignment of data formats. Another way to get any useful information is using of existing international databases. You can see the names of a number of them, the mainly part they're for oceanography, but also they're for biology and so on. And they keep a lot of information of results of previous studies, which also can be used for the understanding of environmental baseline in contract areas. And but a question about alignment of data formats arise in this relation too. And for example, Ephemer is a manager such databases like Coriolis Data Center. And also it works with satellite remote sensing data. It's a satellite ocean laboratory in Ephemer. And I guess that it will be very useful if our French colleagues share with us the experience in using of this data and maybe the experience in the using of data of satellite remote sensing. And for realization of all these points about which I mentioned about organization of collaborative cruises looks a very useful and a very good way. And a great example of such collaboration is a cruise DI-56, which were organized by our Chinese colleagues in last year. And this cruise followed up to results of the workshop on the development of regional environmental management plan for cobalt-rich ferromanganese crust in the Northwest Pacific Ocean. The workshop was in 2018, and the next year, Chinese contractor organized this cruise. And as you can see, they worked at six areas. All of them were outside contract areas, and it was international team of scientists there from China, from Japan, from Russia, and they studied biology, geology, physical and chemical oceanography, and I guess that results of this cruise give a good input for the further development of regional environmental management plan for this triangle area. And in the first half of the next 2021 year, in Russia, we will discuss the possible plans for cruises for the next 2022 year. And we very hope try to organize a big cruise to the northern part of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. Of course, its realization of these plans depends on a lot of conditions, of course, as it's usual, but we hope that maybe it will be successful and we can invite our colleagues to discuss the possible plans, possible programs for this cruise when we start to discuss this issue inside our country. Of course, organization of such cruises and other realization of possible of important points for monitoring is increasing of collaboration between contractors, and it could be developed in two ways. From one side, it's direct contact between representatives of contractors. For example, I'm an oceanographer, but I do not know any oceanographers from Ephemera or from Poland. I know biologists from them, but I don't have contacts with oceanographers. But if we want to collaborate, we need to communicate with each other. to discuss any different issues, to exchange our point of views and so on. And the other way of collaboration is development of joint research program. And in this, I guess, a creation of any forum among representatives of contractors for development of such programs can be very useful. And from other side, maybe any recommendation from the IFSA regarding coordination of studies, direction of research, filling of gaps and others can be very useful. But from the other side, the preparing of such recommendation can give additional burden on the IFSA, but the IFSA is rather busy currently. So it's a question to the IFSA, is it possible? So it was the main points about improvement of monitoring and collaboration between contractors, and finally, a few conclusive remarks. So effective performance by contractors of their responsibilities for environmental baseline studies and monitoring requires from contractors to enhance their cooperation, to establish and expand communication both at level, at official level and at the expert level. Also, coordination of research programs, standardization of methods and techniques for measurements, for sampling, for analysis, for interpretations of the results obtained. Standardizations of requirements for data storage and exchange, harmonization of studies in time and space, all of this is necessary. And of course, make any researches outside contract areas, a collaborative cruises is one of the very perspective ways in this regard. And from the ISA, I guess, very important, the development of framework for studies outside contract areas, including APIs. Very useful will be recommendations regarding field knowledge gaps and appropriate volumes of studies. And of course, the coordination of contractors' efforts by workshops, maybe by other any activities, also will be very useful. That's all. Thank you for your attention.